Hey there, Cube Nation. Congratulations on receiving your Cube freeze dryer. Exciting days are ahead. Now that you have your freeze dryer unboxed and set up ready to turn on, let's go through the initial tests to make sure everything is running correctly, ready for your first cycle. First, remove everything but the shelves from inside of the freeze dryer chamber. Next, make sure that you plug in your cube directly into an outlet. Don't use an extension cord. Once you have it plugged in, you can turn on the freeze dryer with the switch on the back panel. Also notice that there is a USB port next to the power switch. If the time comes that a firmware update becomes necessary or desired, this is where you will plug in a USB drive. And make a note that your serial number is listed right underneath the barcode above the switch panel. The screen will take approximately 15 seconds to boot up before you get to the start screen. At this point, you will want to make sure that your door is adjusted correctly to make a seal. And close the drain valve. Press the start button. Then press the gear icon in the lower right corner of the screen. Next, press the test button. You see the options to turn on the three main functions of the freeze dryer. Press the vacuum button to turn on the vacuum pump. You will hear the noise of the pump turning on. And within 30 seconds, and you will not be able to open the door at all. If, however, you are able to open the door, some minor adjustments will need to be made to the door. Turn off your vacuum pump and open the drain valve. Let's go through the door adjustment process now so that it is ready when you do the rest of the tests. During shipping, the door may get out of adjustment, so let's just make sure that it's ready for you. Also, after the first and maybe the second batches, you may want to check your door as the cabinet settles into its new home.
You'll want to tighten the hinge screws all the way until they stop, but make sure you straighten the hinges throughout the process so they do not bind crooked or too far out. When the screw is all the way in, the hinge should look straight like this and about a quarter inch from the cabinet face. Using your Phillips screwdriver again, turn the hinge plate screws counterclockwise to loosen them a full turn and a half. I often have to count the tines on the screwdriver 6 times to make sure I do this correctly. When you are done, your door should spring open just like this, but still be able to close. Tighten the Phillips screw until you see the magnet plate pull away from the back of the magnet on the door. Then loosen it just enough to touch the door again. Try to slide the paper in between the door and the gasket. If it slides in on the hinge side, tighten the closest hinge plate screw as shown. If it slides in on the magnet side, readjust the magnet plate as shown in step 7.
Now, let's test the door seal again. Make sure that the drain valve is closed. Now, turn on the vacuum pump. If we did our job correctly, then the door will seal. You may need very minor adjustments after this, but only very small. Turn off the vacuum pump and open the drain valve to release the vacuum in the chamber. We will now run a test of all the functions of the freeze dryer as found in the beginning of the owner's manual. First, we will turn on the freezer by pressing the freezer button. Notice the temperature of the chamber underneath the freezer button. It will likely be close to your ambient temperature if this is the first time being turned on. Now, we're going to set a timer for 30 minutes. This will allow all the moisture inside the chamber to freeze. You don't need to sit by the cube during this time. I will come back to you in 30 minutes. All right, it has been 30 minutes and our temperature has gone down quite a bit. We're going to test the vacuum, but do not turn off the freezer. If we turn off the freezer, then the moisture will begin to melt and affect the vacuum readings. Make sure the drain valve is closed. Make a mental note of the vacuum reading underneath the vacuum button. It will likely be somewhere above 15,000. Now, turn the vacuum on. Make sure the door seals before walking away. If it doesn't, then push the door against the cabinet until it does seal. Once the door begins to seal, set another timer for 30 minutes, and then you can walk away. Our vacuum's been running for 30 minutes. Now, check the vacuum reading below the vacuum button. Your freeze dryer should show somewhere below 500. If it doesn't, then record what it does show and contact customer support. Remember, if you turned your freezer off before now, your vacuum readings will be high. At this point, you can turn off the freezer and the vacuum. Also, release the vacuum by opening the drain valve. Now turn on the heater. We are going to wait until the temperature reads 130 degrees. This may take several minutes, so set a reminder to come back in 3 to 4 minutes. The heater will automatically turn off at 130 degrees, so if it's off when you return, don't worry. As long as the temperature is between 115 and 130 degrees, you will be able to feel the heat. Open the acrylic door. You are going to feel every shelf and the top heater to make sure they feel warm. Start at the bottom. The bottom shelf will still be cool to the touch because all the cold is trapped there from having the freezer on. But hopefully it will at least feel warmer than the outer walls of the freeze dryer. Don't worry if this feels significantly cooler than the other shelves, but you can feel the other shelves and the top heater with your hand and will notice they will be warm to the touch. That's it. Your cube passed all the tests and now it's ready to run food. A few words of advice before you really get going on freeze-drying food. First, the more even in thickness you can cut your food, the better your results will be. Second, to start out, don't stack your food, just do single layers. Third, start with smaller batches to be most successful to begin with. We are all excited to freeze dry as much food as we possibly can on our first batch. It is possible, however, to overload the freeze dryer and get to the point where you are freeze drying ice rather than the food. So start small. Strawberries are a favorite, so I would recommend starting like this. As you become more comfortable with the process, you can add more and more food to the trays and determine what works best. We recommend that if your batch gets to around 45 hours, you likely have too much ice built up. At that point, cancel the process, remove the food, and put it in your home freezer. You don't have to throw it away. Defrost the cube and remove all the ice. Then you can put the food back in the freeze dryer and start the batch over. It'll likely be finished in a short period of time, maybe 10 to 15 hours. Remember, start small and then get bigger and bigger in your batches. Foods that are high in water content will take longer than foods that don't. Now, you're ready to start freeze drying in your own home. We're excited to hear what fun things you are freeze drying with your cube. Post it on social media and tag us at Cube Nation. Or send us an email. We are so excited to share this journey with you. Happy freeze drying and welcome to Cube Nation.